Anyway, continue on. Expanding legal migration and deterring illegal migration. Just make it 100% legal. That's if you want. Okay. If you want to deter illegal activity, legalize those like non-consensual crimes or those like no victimless crimes. That's the word I'm looking for. Victimless crimes. Legalize all those victimless crimes. You're not. That's the best way to deter something that's illegal. Anyway, let's explore. I think this kind of issue. America is a nation of immigrants. Well, that's because we also genocide the indigenous people. That's why. The legal immigration framework was like last updated in 1990, and doesn't reflect the needs of our country in the 21st century. It's an open debate what those needs are, but like continuing on. Many immigrants today are forced to like wait years and often decades to like immigrate lawfully in the United States of America. I remember like years ago of like one lady, I think she was Vietnamese or like Japanese, and she showed one of those cases just fell through the cracks as well too. It's like, oh, we're not sure we have the processes, and she was been waiting for decades all her life. She's been living here in the United States like on an exemption or something, as she's like waiting for her appointment or waiting for her trial to or waiting for like the citizenship paperwork to go through or something like that. And she even like said in jest that like she might die still an immigrant and not a legal citizen, and despite being living in the United States of America for like decades. I think she, yeah Vietnamese woman as well too. Anyway, that's the part I did read. Continue on. A robust immigration system with accessible law pathways and penalties for illegal immigration alleviates pressure at the border and upholds our values. The U.S. Citizenship Act would permanently increase family support and employment based on immigration. The bipartisan border legislation would increase the number of immigrants visas that are available by 250,000 over the 5 years. And that seems like a low number to me, honestly. Oh, yeah, I have seen that style. Yeah, and then, like, as Hap said, it is a very common era. But... Oh, yeah, so there was also a Polish man who couldn't speak English and was, like, murdered by the cops at that TSA because they could not be, like, bothered to get a translator. Yeah. Cops doing cops things doesn't surprise me either. But anyway, continue on. Legal immigration pathways. Is I will also say this, I've seen like a lot of like just like super pro like Russian like leftists as well too, and just like I don't understand some of those people, but there's also been like there's like MAGA communists, like a strange kind of like patriarch like leftists as well too, and but I'm against all states and I have my many criticisms of the United States of America. Speaking of which, legal immigration pathways. While we wait for Congress to act, President Biden has like used his authority to provide orderly immigration, legal immigration pathways for those fleeing violence and decrease the number of illegal border crossings. Yeah, make it super easy to come here and then decrease the illegal border crossings. The Biden-Harris administration established a humanitarian parole process for Cubans. A leftist who's a pro-DAP, pro-Russia, pro-Venezuela is either misinformed or not a leftist. It's usually the former, but, like, people are very fucking stubborn. I'm not going to disagree with you there, Hops. Like, I just have some people who really believe Russia is still communist are weirdos. I agree. I think we can all agree on that. People who still believe, who still think that Russia is still communist, those, I don't understand you. It's like, now, when it stopped being communist, that's, we can have that debate on that as well, too. Because I think so far, the consensus was there was a time where they, like, the USSR was, like, started to be more capitalistic, more liberal, like, more liberalized as well, too, which caused fall as well. Oh. Yeah. Also, the events were offended that they care about the Cubans. Yeah, agreed. App, stop the blockade. Cuba is one of those things. I really want to actually like educate myself on Jacob Rauer and like Fidel Castro, because I do have someone who's half Cuban that personally hates both, honestly, of Che Guevara and Fidel Castro as well, too. Oh, so that's why they personally hate how, like, many leftists are so... I think, like, Fidel Castro did nothing wrong as well, too. I think, like, Che Guevara being, like, lionized as much as he does is, like, overblown as well, too. Now, did he did some bad things? Maybe he did. But, like, I want to at least learn... I want to do my own research on Che Guevara and Fidel Castro, and both characters as well, too. Because I'm willing to say that both are complex people as well, too. I'm not going to, like, say either way that they're either of them are a monster or either of them are saints or angels. Because I think the majority of people are just, like, complex in that way, too. Like, even Marx himself, like Engels, I have my disagreements with those ones. It's more philosophical disagreements as well, too. And like a lot of other things, Che and Castro were bad communists, and I'm not pro-Cuba ML, but like I do think both were trying to like lead an anti-imperialist like revolution. I will agree, from what I understand, I would agree with you there. They were trying. As like I definitely believe in Che Guevara was definitely believe in his cause as well, too. And I think the Castro, for the most part, was, because, like, yeah. And I'm not super pro-Cuban either, too, because I'm generally not pro-states anyway. Continue on. The Biden-Harris administration established a humanitarian power process for Cubans, Haitians, Nicaraguans, and Venezuelans. All four countries we interfere with heavily in their economies and their governments. I mean, if you don't want people to, like, come to, like, those countries or flee these countries, someone then stop messing with them. Like, end the blockade on, like, Cuba. Allow them to, like, freely trade to whoever. Stop messing with, like, the presidents of, like, Haiti. I also don't stop imposing, like, IMF or, like, World Bank, like, structural adjustment programs on them as well, too. Stop interfering in the elections with, like, Nicaragua. And stop saying that Juan Guaido was the legitimate president of, like, Venezuela, too, and interrupting them as well, too. Again, not supporting these countries as well, too. It's crazy how they're all basically banana republics and sugar colonies. Agree with you there, Harps. Anyway, continue on. Which allows for these four countries who have, like, sponsored in the United States of America, U.S., and who passes a background check to come to the United States for a period of 2 years to, like, live and work lawfully. I mean, I think, there's something to be said at least about, like, I think Barack Obama, who opened things up, like, a bit for, like, Cuba. Honestly, as, like, for NATO, I don't like them as much as I can throw them. They do have a second, like, aiding, like, Ukraine by taking Putin in the face value when he's a known liar. There's that as well, too. Again, not a fan of NATO. I think we can agree on that. I'm just against, like, any kind of imperialism, regardless of who's it's from. I think we can agree on that. Well, at least that's my stance, and, like, yeah. But anyway. No worry, people. Foreign policy will be, like, either later on in the stream or a future stream, so... Maybe it'll be the next chapter. No, it's the last chapter, unfortunately. So I'm not sure, this is chapter 7. I'm not sure I'll be able to get to the foreign policy part of this document, like, in this stream. I'm going to be streaming till 7, which is about, like, 5 hours from now. And I've already gone about almost 3 hours, so there's that. I'll tap out at some point, but probably not after I finish the chapter, but, like, in the middle of the next chapter. And... Anyway, continue on. Border encounters from these nationalities decreased by 89% in the first 6 months after CHNV was put in place, incentivizing migrants to stay in place rather than make the dangerous journey to our southwest border. The stay in Mexico policy! Actually, I kind of do agree with you there. No, they're just not there. They'll help Ukraine. Yeah, exactly. Yeah, exactly, Exile. We can agree with that. They're helping, their foreign policies are helping Israel do war crimes against the Palestinian and Lebanese people. Exactly. Because they have to, because again, apparently Israel has to destroy Hamas and Hezbollah. I will be honest, Hezbollah is, like, an entity I want to, like, do my own research on. Because I'm not going to just, like... So maybe they're not great. I can imagine that. But, like, I don't want to automatically assume that, like, Hezbollah are also bad guys just because, like, liberals are told to not like Hezbollah. Maybe there's some awful things that Hezbollah has done, but so I will, like, leave my mind open on that. But, like, I want to actually do my own research on Hezbollah. But anyway, but, like, innocent civilians had, like, a pager blown off in their hands, blown up in their hands and next to their face. Should be critical of both groups, but we can also acknowledge that they're a primary force of fighting against ongoing genocide. Yeah, tarps. I mean, yeah, it's like Hamas did horrible war crimes. I won't like apologize. I won't like make. I will acknowledge just that too. But right now, Hamas is like the Palestinian people are like experiencing genocide, and it's like that has to stop. That's just flat out has to stop as well too. Sorry, clicking on something on like the next stream over. Anyway, now rearranging my second monitor so that I can like see the chats as well too. Russia, the U.S. cares about like Russia because like they don't like Russia doing the imperialism, and they want to do the imperialism too. This is why they're also like so anti-China as well too, because like they hate how like China is trying to be an economic power. But maybe some people just like have a whole over. Yeah, no. I remember hearing about that as well too. No, that yeah. The Tim Pool and Dave Rubin were paid to be like shills for Russia by the Russian government. The Russian government played a shell game to do that, but, like, yeah, they did that. When you listen to, like, Tim Pool for sure, and maybe Dave Rubin, of how, like, anti-Ukraine they are, so that's like, wow, you're being the shield of Putin. Hope that paycheck is wonderful for you guys. Anyway, continue on. He also established, like, new family reunification parole process to allow eligible, like, citizen individuals from the South, Guatemala, Honduras, Colombia, Cuba, Haiti to be reunited with families in the United States as while they wait to complete the process for securing lawful like permanent residence. Again, a lot of countries we interfere in there are like either governments or like or the economies. So continuing on, the United States have like has long been like, and I'm glad to see you then too have like came to a mutual place of like agreement on things too. And upon more positive, I have again like game mastered a Witcher tabletop game and for a party of four, the party fought four living armors. Nice. The Witcher games I should get back to, honestly. I played the first one, and actually really did enjoy it. I should play the other ones. Even though I got, the Witcher skins and, like, a fork knife as well, too. Well, Drew Off from River was a Battle Pass skin, Secret Battle Pass skin in Chapter 4, Season 1. And then, but, like, they included Syria and Yennefer in the item shop. Anyway. For some reason, they, like, held... What? Okay, you two. What? Okay. All the other times that, like, other messages that were held is because of curse words in the earth. I understand that, YouTube. That's nice. But, like, why did YouTube, did you held Habsburg's, like, a question of, am I dyslexic? Which, actually, I am. Harps. Question. No, I am dyslexic as well, too. That one's confirmed. I was tested and it's been confirmed. My dad has dyslexia and he does really actually read at a lower speed than like most other people as well too. And so me and my other siblings inherited from him. So yeah, that is true. I am dyslexic. Anyway, which is why sometimes I have struggled reading words when I read these documents. Anyway. I continue on. The United States has been like a leader in refugee resettlement, providing a beacon of hope for prosecuting the people around the world, facilitating international efforts to address like record displacement, and demonstrating the generous like core values of the American people. Don't feel like you have to like read every mention out loud, though, if you like need to read them fast. No, that's okay. I probably will acknowledge the messages as well, too, or try to. But it's like. Granted, I don't have to, like, read messages. There was a time when I wanted to, like, take these, like, VODs of my streams and, like, post them as a podcast, which is why I was, like, interested in, like, reading the messages out loud for these reading streams, honestly. So that's why. And it still carry over, even though I haven't started a podcast whatsoever. But I'm also, but definitely for sure, like, some of these, like, VODs, or some of these past streams that I put up on YouTube and other places as well, too, some people would treat this as if, like, it's a podcast or, like, they have it on the background and as well, too. So that's why I kind of acknowledge the chats and, like, say, so-and-so said it in chat and that sort of thing, too, as I'm reading this. But do we actually think that, like, the United States is the beacon of hope for people that are trying, that are fleeing persecution? Because, like, for some people that are fleeing persecution, they get more persecuted when they get, they're still persecuted when they get here, or more persecuted when they get here. Didn't we just, like, read the sections about, like, legal immigration and illegal immigration? But anyway, I love the city of, are you screaming about my magical girl stuff? I could do it. After Trump decimated the program, I think it's decimated. President Biden rebuilt the U.S. refugee immigration program, which is now on track to, like, admit more than 100,000 refugees this fiscal year, more and the most in three decades. There's something tells me they could do more, but anyway, the administration also established, like, the self-mobility, like, offices in, like, countries throughout the Western Hemisphere where migrants can be processed for refugees administration or referred to resettlement programs elsewhere. America literally bad at welcoming asylum seekers and non-white immigrants. Agreed, Azel. Yeah, I forgot the exact number, but it's like a 1/4, like, Cuban immigrants, like, go back to Cuba. Like, imagine leaving a poor island nation under a blockade, seeing the United States and going, nah, this is not a downgrade. Mm-hmm. Let's see. Where migrants can be processed for refugees administration or referred to, like, resettlement programs elsewhere, rather than making their way to our border. They're really saying don't come, honestly, aren't they, with these passages? But anyway. And the administration expanded, like, opportunities for communities and individual Americans to sponsor and welcome refugees to the United States of America. Okay, they should do a lot more of that and welcome more people in, but, like, okay. President Biden had worked closely with partners throughout the region, including, most importantly, the government of Mexico, to undertake cooperative actions to stop the flow of migrants before they reach our borders, and has, like, supported, like, our regional partners through the LA declaration process, worked together on coordinated enforcement deployments of law and lawful pathways and efforts to address the root cause of migration. The root cause of migration is you destabilizing so many countries. The root cause of migration is also capitalism. The root cause of migration is, like, the NAFTA deal. So until you, like, solve those problems as well too, you're just like, you're gonna people still coming here as well too. You don't want, like, people come here. Don't fuck with our countries. Continuing. As outlined in the United States Citizenship Act, Congress must, like, act to increase the number of family-supported, like, and employment-based immigrant-like visas that are available each fiscal year so that people aren't forced to, like, decades for, like, visa. Legislation should also include provisions to ensure the children who came as dependents on their parents' temporary visas can remain in the United States with their families, even after, like, turning 21. Provisions to, like, streamline applications for of at-risk Afghan allies or their U.S. refugee administration program and a process for Afghan evacuees to help their status, like, just like to lawful permanent residence. They were kind of bad about doing that for the Afghan people that, like, help us. The problem with the U.S. federal level is that they don't see themselves. Oh, I have to, like, show that. The problem with the U.S. federal law, they don't see themselves as the problem, but blame everything else. Yeah, and part of that, they want to, like, work with their partners as well, too, because they want people to, like, stay in Mexico as well, too, while they process their claims. And then once their number has come up, here you go, come over as well, too. Illegal immigration are actually discussing a way that bolsters the United States slave economy. Stronger boomers equal more illegal immigrants that will work below minimum wage in terrible conditions. I agree there, Hopper. Anyway, continue on. Illustration should also exceed work authorization to those who initialize lawful, like a visa pathway, so that my family can move quickly and get on the path to economic self-sufficiency. This includes K-1, K-2, and K-3 non-immigrant, like visa holders, fiancé, spouses, and children of U.S. citizens, and the spouses of children of high-skilled, like I want to highlight this part. High skill. How to determine this high skill? I kind of hate that, like, the inhalation of someone who's, like, high skill or something like that. We only want highly skilled people to come here. We only want the best. A.K.A. the rich. Continue on. And children of high skill, temporary visa holders. So they have to prove themselves, honestly. Then the children can say, I hate that. Continuing on. And Democrats will explore opportunities to identify or create work permits for immigrants, long-term undocumented residents, and legally possessed, like, asylum seekers in our country. Legally processed asylum seekers in our country. I said possess, and that when it's supposed to be processed, right? They're being possessed by something! What? Anyway, me misspoken as well, too. Congress should also increase the number of visas for special immigrants' juvenile status programs for abuse, abandoned, or neglected youth. Buildings on actions that the administration has actually taken to provide deterrent actions and work authorizations for juveniles in this program. We might consider, like, giving papers to these people, maybe, if you feel like it. Yeah, that's how it feels like. Harps. Outro video time! Yes, this time I'm actually making an outro video instead of just having text up here. So, if you liked the video, press the button to give it a like. Helps out the video as well, too. And if you dislike the video, that button is there, too, as well. Oh, doesn't matter. Helps the algorithm and helps the video either way. You can also leave a comment if you disagree with something that I said, or you just want to say, hey, I like this video, or something like that. That will help out the video as well, too. Don't forget to subscribe if you haven't already as well, too. Getting those subs numbers up always helps as well, too. And also, don't forget to share around the video to, like, all your friends, all your enemies on the social medias and be like, hey, check this out, or listen to this, or will you check out this person that's rambling about so many different things. Yeah, that will help the video as well, too. And also, over on the sides of my face right now, or covering the face as well, too, should be, like, the buttons for, like, over here for, like, to subscribe to the channel if you haven't already, and also Social Justice Alchemy if you haven't checked out that, like, a channel. It's a weekly live stream show, the YouTube live stream show that I'm sitting around with a bunch of my friends, a bunch of other anarchists and leftists and socialists to talk about, like, current events, news, politics, feminism, anarchism, socialism, communism, and various other things, even cats, even, like, pop culture as well, too. And over on, like, here should be some videos as well, too, for, like, that I recommend you check out as well. Or it's over here. That's, I don't know. Around my face, there should be those buttons that you can click on as well, too. All right, thank you for watching.